Okay, so I hope everybody has understood the concept of pivoting and how it improves accuracy. अरे कोणाला कळलं का?
यस सर।
ओके फाइन. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द अनदर प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज अ टिपिकल प्रॉब्लम विच आई एम टेकिंग इट. 3x प्लस 6y प्लस जेड इक्वल टू 16. देन आई हैव 2x प्लस 4y प्लस 3z इक्वल टू 13. देन आई हैव एक्स प्लस 3y प्लस 2z इज इक्वल टू 9. ओके सो यू कुड सी दिस इक्वेशन इज this system is okay. You have to select option A, B. So pivoting, and of course I am talking about partial, is required or it is already partial pivoted. Okay, so you can type the option A or B in group. Please fast everyone. काय करतात बाकीचे? चला लवकर टाईप करा. ओके सो इट इज बी. ऑफ कोर्स इट इज ऑलरेडी पार्शियल पिवोटेड. ओके सो एज वी नो ना कि मैक्सिमम एक्स 3, देन फ्रॉम रिमेनिंग मैक्सिमम वाई इज 4. सो 4, सो दिस इज पार्शियली पिवोटेड. ओके नाउ आई राइट कोएफिशिएंट मैट्रिक्स 3, 6, 1, 2, 4, 3, 1, 3, 2, x1, x2, x3, and then we can write 16, 13, and 9. Okay. Now what we know, we have to make this 0 and this 0. Okay. So therefore R2 will change to R2 minus numerator plus 2, denominator plus 3 into R1. So this is what is the operation I am going to do. So that operation is 3, 6, 1. And I will be having the x1, x2, x3 is equal to 16 and this. Okay. So if I do that, so I get put 2 minus plus 2, 3 into 3 equal to 0. So I got 0 here. Next target is what? So I have 4 minus plus 2 divided by plus 3 into 6. So 3 to the 6. So this is 2. So 2 to the 4, this is 0. Again 0. Okay. Then next one is 3 minus 2 by 3 into 1. So 3 minus 2 by 3. So how much this is? Okay, so I got 2.33. Now I have to go for this. So 13 minus 2 by 3 into 16. So 13 minus 2 divided by 3. So this is not my scientific calculator. So anybody could tell me this value, please? Okay. I do have the calculator. So 13 minus 2 divided by 3 into 16. Okay, so 2.33 again. So just verify whether I am doing correctly or not. Okay. Then for this I have to do R3 will change to R3 minus 1. So plus sign plus 3. Okay, into R1. So this will come to 0. Then next is 3 minus 1 divided by 3 into 6. So 3 to the 2, 6. So that comes to be 1. And I have 2 minus 1 by 3 into 1. So 0.33 subtract karenge. So 1.6666. Okay, and then finally I'll be having a 9 minus 1 by 3 into 16. So 9 minus 1 by 3 into 16. So this is 3.667. Okay, so this way I'm getting it. Now what the trouble is, this diagonal is 0, so I cannot make this 0. Though I have done the partial POT, I still cannot make this 0 because this diagonal element is 0, though this has a solution. So here in this case, what I do, I again go for POT. Okay. And such pivoting I called as intermediate pivoting. Okay, so after doing the pivoting, what system I am going to get? 3, 6, 1, 0, 1, 2.33, because 1 is larger, so it will go 0 will come down. Then 0, 0, 1.66, 6. And then I can say x1, x2, x3 is equal to 16, 3.667, and then 2.333. So what I got an upper triangular form. Now I can use back substitution to find all x values. So this is up to you to sort. Okay, so this part is homework for you. Now again I write the same system of equation, 3x. So here my problem ends. So solution finding is yours. 3x plus 6y plus z is equal to 16. Same problem I am taking. 2x plus 4y plus 3z is equal to 13. X plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 9. Okay, this is what is partially pivoted. Now we need to also see what is full pivoting. Okay, it is a concept. So first find out the maximum value from the equation. So I see absolute, of course we have to consider absolute value. So 6 is a maximum and it is a coefficient of y. So therefore plus 6y plus z equal to 16, this will be my equation number 2. Okay, now this is gone. Find out next maximum value from the remaining 2 equation. Okay, so from this, what is the maximum value remaining? Is the 3. Okay, it is the 3. If I see, I have the 3 maximum because y value we have the consideration. So only z and x. So I have the 3 max. Okay, this is 2, this is 1, 2, so 3 max. So it is z. So therefore, I will get 2x plus 4y plus 3z is equal to 13. This is equation number 3. And finally, I have this as a x plus 3y plus 2z is equal to 9. So this will be my equation number. So if I do this way, this is I called as a full pivoting. As I can see, all the max element are coming in the diagonal location. So this is the one way to understand what is the full pivoting concept. Okay, so full pivoting does solve many problems which is not solved by the partial pivoting. So this is only for you. Okay, so just a concept, nothing else. It won't come in any kind of problem. What is full pivoting or perform the full pivoting on such system of equation, some such type of questions will be there. Okay, so you should be aware of. So if the question comes in terms of MCQ, then this question is very important. Okay. So in this way, we have completed the first method, that is called as Gauss elimination with partial pivoting. Okay. Now the next method is TDMA. So TDMA is a special version of Gauss elimination method. It is a special version of Gauss elimination method, and we require a special system which can be solved with the help of this. Okay. So one of the important requirement is that the matrix should be diagonally symmetric. That is one of the requirement. Okay. So not diagonally symmetric, it should be diagonally dominant, and then it should have a 3 band. So that is what is the related to TDMA. Okay, so how much time is left? Okay, 15 minutes. So okay, no problem, we will go with the small program of this, or we'll go with TDMA. That is what is the thing. So just we'll go with the TDMA. So that will be a lot easier. Okay. Because we need the banded system. So this is applicable for banded matrix. Okay. So TDMA stands for Thomas algorithm or tri-diagonal matrix algorithm. Okay, Thomas algorithm or tri-diagonal matrix algorithm. So three diagonals are there. So I have the equation 10x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 12. Then I have 2x1 plus 9x2 plus 3x3 is equal to 14. Then I have x2 plus 10x3 plus 4x4 is equal to 15. Then I have 3x3 plus 11x4 is equal to 40. Okay. So if I write, so this system is already pivoted. So it's band basically. Okay. So I have 10, 2, 0, 0. Then I have 2, 9, 3, 0, 0, 1, 10, 4, 0, 0, 3, 11, and I can write this as a x1, x2, x3, x4. Okay, and I can write here 12, 14, 15, and back to 40. So, actually it is a special case of Gauss elimination method. What you observe that most of the terms are already zero. Okay, most of the terms are already zero. So what zero you have to make? So first is this one, this I have to make zero. Second one is this one, and the third one is this one. So I can see that using this row I have to make this zero, then using this row I have to make this zero, and using this row I have to make this zero. So only once operation you have to perform using the row 1. Other operation I don't have to perform because they are already 0. So I can say if you perform the operation of elimination by only once, that method is I called as a tri-diagonal matrix algorithm or the Thomas algorithm. So it's a special case of what you say Gauss elimination method. So I just do a banding. So this is my band 1. This is my band 2. And this is my band 3. So I have 1, 2, 3 bands. And that is why I call this as a tri. Okay. So tri-diagonal means 3 banded system. So I have the 3 diagonals, 3 bands, and then we have to work out. So it is a special case. So I can dictate this as a A matrix, this as a B matrix, and this as a C matrix. So how do I write? So my A matrix will be, first nothing will be there, 2, 1, 3. So this is my A band. Okay. And then I will be having a B band. B band will be 10, 9, 10, 11. Okay. Now constant matrix I call as a D. This is my C band now. So I will bring it 2, 3, 4, and this term does not exist. And my D matrix, that is my D band, will be 12, 14, 15, and 14. Okay, so in this way, I have the 3 bands. Okay, so now I have to make these 2 elements as 0. Okay, so to make 2 elements 0, I need to find out M first. So M, I will get it from here. Okay, so with the help of this, I get M. So what is M? M equal to 2 by 10. So this is how I got the M. Okay, so M is the multiplying factor. Then what should I do? Okay, I have to make this element change. Okay, so how I'm going to do? So this is going to change. So this 9 is going to change. How it is going to change? It is going to change by 9 minus 2 into M. So this is what is the operation. And what about this? So this is also going to change to this. And what is going to change? 14 minus 12 into M. So this is how it is going to change. So let's rewrite the banded A. So A will be my dash. This becomes 0 automatically. Okay. And then so with this I got M as 2 by 10. So either you make 0 or keep 2, doesn't make any difference. Okay. Then I keep this as a 1, this as a 3. This will be 10. And this 9 minus 2 into M. So M is 2 by 10. So it will be 0.2, I have to subtract. So this becomes 8.8. So this is my B. Okay, so this will be 2, 3, 4 and this. This will be 12, 14 minus 12 into 0.2. So this is 6. So this comes 8. Okay, what is the next operation? From this I have to get M. Okay. So now, but that m has changed now. That m is 1 by 8.8. So this is my m. Okay. Now what operation I have to do? So this is 10. This is 11. So this is the operation which I have to do. That is 10 minus 3 into m. So here 15 and 14. And now what operation I have to do here in this case is 15 minus 8 into m. So I rewrite the matrix again. 0, so it becomes 0 now. Okay. So this is 10, this is 8.8. Now this is going to change. So 10 minus 3 into 1, 3 into m. So this is 3, 3 into m. M is 8.8. No, sorry, not 8.8. 1 divided by 8.8. Okay, so 10 minus 1 divided by 8.8. So it comes around 9.8863. Okay. So this is my B. This is C. This is D. So C remains 2, 3, 4 dash, and D remains 12, 8. Okay, so this is now 15 minus 8. So I made the mistake here, I think so. So 10 minus 3 divided by 8.8. So it is 9.65. So it is 9.6590. Okay, so this is 10 minus 3 into m. Okay, I just took it to 1m. And here in this case, 15 minus 8 divided by 8.8. So that's coming around 14.0909. Now this will be 14. Okay. And this is 3. This is 11. So this is going to give me m as 3 divided by 9.6590. And now this is going to change 11 minus 4 into m, and this is going to change 14 minus 14.0909 into m. So I just keep on doing the operation again. Dash 0, 0, this becomes 0. 10, 8.8, 9.659. So m is my, so 11 minus 4 divided by, sorry, pahle multiply, into 3 divided by 9.659. Syntax error. Minus 4 into 3 divided by 9.659. Okay, so I got some value. 9.7576. Okay. So I have 2, 3, 4 dash, and then I'll be having this 12, 8, 14.0909, and this is what I have to calculate. 14 minus 14.0909 into 3 divided by 9.6590. So this is coming around 9.63744, something like this. Okay, so you can verify, I might have made the calculation mistake. Okay, abhi calculator itna swiftly use nahi kar sakta ho. ओके, सो गलती हुई है मुझसे. सो आई जस्ट करेक्टेड बिकॉज आई ऑलरेडी हैव सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम एंड दैट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. सो आई हैव द वैल्यू हियर 13.6512. Okay, and because of that, this value will also come to 9.7576. Okay, so ultimately what you can do now, you can go for the back substitution. So this is your A, this is your B, this is your C, this is your D. So how do I get x4 I get as D4 divided by B4. So it is 9.7576 divided by 9.7576 is equal to 1. Now how do I get x3? x3 I get as, it is D4 minus C3 into x4 divided by B3. Okay, so D4 is 13.6512 minus C3 is 4, X4 is 1. Okay, divided by (9.659). So approximately this turn out to be also 1. Okay. Similarly, x2.
Okay, so there is a electricity failure at my end. Okay, so you can start leaving it. We will continue next time. Okay, so I'll just leave the problem here itself and we'll continue next time. Thank you.